Hey guys, hope everyone's doing well. Wanted to come by and share my new beauty with me. This is the Michael Kors Dillon, hold on a minute, large crocodile pattern embossed leather tote. I will put the link in the description box if you want to go check out the site for yourself. My husband got this for me. It's actually a late birthday present. He wasn't able to get it when he saw it in the store. They couldn't sell it to him at the time. I think it was before, this bag was released a couple weeks ago, so I think that's probably why. I don't think it was like in their system in the store yet, so they couldn't like physically sell it to him. But anyway, I carried this bag for the first time yesterday and I love it. I love the smell of new leather. So I sniff my bag a lot. But this is a Michael Kors Dillon crocodile embossed tote. If you want a close up of the embossing, that's what it looks like. I think it's really cool, and I love that it's red because I really like a red bag. I used to have a red bag years ago. It was an Alfani bag that I bought at Macy's. Well, actually, my husband got it for me for my birthday, and I wore that bag to the ground, and since then, I've been looking for a bag to replace it, and I've never been able to find one, and he found one for me. So yeah, I'm really happy. So I guess I'll just go through the features of the bag. It's full because I'm using it. So it's just an open top. It doesn't have a zipper, but it has this inside zippered compartment. And top handles, which is usually how I carry my bag, but I left the strap on because I think I like how it looks. I'm not sure. I'm still deciding. But I've left the strap on, and while I was traveling, I did use it crossbody. But just for like a few minutes while I was going through customs and picking up my suitcases and stuff like that. So yeah, this is what it looks like. It's new, so I don't know if you can hear that. It's still squeaky because it's stiff, but that's okay. I know that will go away. The leather is, I thought it would have been a more structured bag. Like I thought it would have been harder leather, but the leather is actually, like, if you can see that, the leather is actually pretty soft, which is nice. It feels really nice. And it doesn't have, I don't like the MK all over the place. I like that it's just like really tiny Michael Kors right there, and I don't know why they hid this and didn't leave it out, but whatever. This little MK just peeking out from under there. All the hardware, from what I can see, actually has Michael Kors on it. So this has the MK and it has Michael Kors right here. All these little pieces of hardware have Michael Kors on the side. The clamps for the clasps, I'm sorry, for the shoulder bag also says Michael Kors. Well, these as well. And the feet, bag has feet. And they're all also stamped with Michael Kors. When this bag came, it was gift boxed. But because I was traveling, I wasn't able to bring the box with me, which I wanted to. But unfortunately, it just wouldn't fit in my suitcase. So I had to leave it behind. But it came in a gift box. It comes with a dust bag. It's just a white dust bag with Michael Kors on it. I mean, it's nothing amazing. So yeah, that's pretty much the bag. It has two pockets here, so I just have tissues in this pocket. I'll go through and show you like what this bag carries, so that will also give you an idea of you know, what you'd be able to fit in here. So I have tissues in this little pocket, and in this larger pocket here I have a mirror. This is a Coach mirror, a little solo one. So then in this zipper pocket, which is really flush against the back part, I have a card holder that matches my mirror. I have this little thingy that has business cards in it, which I'm actually going to transfer to something else. And this is the leather care card that came with the bag. It just tells you how to take care of the bag, how to take care of the leather. My gym membership, Goodwill, rewards, Rite Aid stuff. My dog's immunization card. Then I have this wristlet. This is actually a Coach wristlet, and I've hooked it on here, and then I just like drop it into the bag like that. And then this just contains my essentials that you don't need to know about. You know what I mean. Then I have in this little corner right here is my sunglasses. These are Armani Exchange. I've had them for about 5 years. Had them forever. They look like that. Aviators. They're brown. I'm brown. They match me, so I don't have to worry about matching them to my outfit. Then I also have this Coach Cosmetic brush. It's actually a brush case, but I use it as a cosmetics case, so I just have a few little things in there, and my hand cream. This is L'Occitane Delicious Hands with almond milk. It's quite yummy. I also have the rose one, but I haven't used it yet. I'm saving it for what I don't know. And my absolute favorite lip balm of all time, Burt's Bees Beeswax lip balm. And then I have these little things that my mom gave me. She got them in a Sephora, you know, the VIB, they give you the gift with purchase. So she got this Smashbox Full Exposure Mascara. I haven't tried it yet. Some lip gloss, but I really need to get my eyes checked because I cannot read what that is. I have this Rimmel Show Off Lip Lacquer. This is like the perfect nude for me, and I can't remember the color, but I think it's Vegas something. Teeny tiny eyeliner just in case I need that. And then this little Smashbox Exposure eyeshadows. These are called eyeshadows. I'm just gonna leave them in here. I don't know, maybe someday I'll need to put on makeup in an emergency, but usually all I have with me is hand cream, chapstick, lip gloss, eyeliner. That's it. But yeah, this is the perfect size cosmetics case for me. The only thing is it doesn't hold a mirror, but that's all right. The mirror's in another section. This is my planner. I was gonna buy a file of facts, but then I didn't have time to go to Staples or order it from the website to get it in time for when I was coming back. So I just got this at Target, and it's a Mead weekly and monthly planner. From it goes from January to December 2015, and then it has just the monthly planner for November and December. So I just did away with my old one and started using this one, just to get myself used to it, and you know, to see if maybe this will be fine for me for 2015. So that's that. And then I have my Kindle, which I was going to read on the plane, but I didn't because I slept. I don't know why I thought I was gonna read. I always sleep. I had an Essence magazine in here, and I did read through that. I fell asleep like 3 times. So, yeah. In the middle now is... Oh, yeah, let's do the middle. In the middle, I keep my wallet because if roving hands ever get into my bag, then I don't want anyone to get my wallet, you know? And this pocket goes all the way down to the bottom of the bag. See? All the way to the bottom. So, and this is a Coach wallet. I don't remember the name, but it's an accordion wallet. So, there's space for cards on either side. It holds 12 cards, and then you have 2 spaces here. Yeah, 1 space just in front of the cards, 1 space just in front of the cards on the other side. a space in the middle, and then your coin pouch is in the middle. And then I have a pen in my wallet because I don't want to put the pen, this pen, in my bag and mess my bag up. So I keep it in there. And then in this last little pocket right here, I have this pen, which I know is not going to spill. And this teeny tiny little notebook, which is what I use. You know, if you ever meet someone and you have to write things down and you're like, oh, let me get a piece of paper, and then you lose the piece of paper that you wrote the thing on. Yeah, I hate when that happens. So I have this little notebook, and then that way I always know where the stuff that I wrote down is. So that always stays in my bag. So what I'm going to do is just empty. I should have done this before, but just emptying everything out of the bag. Oh, one more thing. I bought this at the Michael Kors outlet. This is not leather, though. No, this is not leather. This is PVC. I bought this at the outlet store, and I wanted to use it as a business card holder, but I have not printed my business cards yet. So that's something I want to do in the new year. You know, more business related stuff. So I'm gonna use this as my business card holder. Anything business related, if I happen to get a business credit card or anything like that, those things will go in here. And any cash and receipts related to business will go in here. So that's what this is for. And it's just in my bag as a placeholder because eventually it's going to be in my bag all the time. So I don't want to be in the habit of putting something else in the space where this is supposed to be, if that makes sense. It is so hot in here. Alright, so this is the bag empty. Alright, this is the middle section. It's pretty big. Right? This is your back section here. It also has a key keeper, which is cool. So I usually put my keys on there, but I don't know where my keys are right now. This is the back zippered section. This is the other side. And then you have your two sections right here. So I put my notebook in one and my phone in the other one. And yeah, that is the bag. I really like it. It smells so good. Again, I'm not sure about the shoulder strap, if I'm going to keep it or if I'm going to take it off, because usually I don't carry my bag on my shoulder. My arms aren't huge, so I actually can carry it like this, which I did today. It just felt more secure that way, and it's not in any way, like, you know, cumbersome or anything. It feels good. I don't have it overstuffed either. But if you do choose to, you can just fold the handles down and carry it squatty like this. And it's fine that way as well. I left the bag how it came, so it is actually on the 1, 2, 3rd hole, and there are 5 holes. So it's actually right smack dab in the middle, and I'm 5'7", so that's how that fits me. Right? You can carry it like this or like this. And the front and back of the bag are pretty much the same. There's no pocket on the back or anything. The only difference is this little charm right here and the Michael Kors logo. One more thing. Right here, if you notice, like, it's not straight across, it dips in right where the handle comes up, and it dips in again here, and also does the same thing on the back. And I've only carried this bag for one day. This is my second day carrying this, and it's already, I can see where the leather is going to change the shape of the bag a little bit, so it's not a rigid structured bag like the Saffiano leather bags would be. This is a definitely like a soft, not completely smushy, but because the bottom is a little reinforced, so it won't slouch completely, but it definitely will change shape slightly over time, and that's okay with me, because that's just how leather is. I don't mind that. This, I don't know if you could hear it, I know that will go away as I use it, but it's a little weird. So yeah, I think I've covered pretty much everything. The glazing on the bag is done well. I like that it has feet, which will definitely protect it. And that's it. I really like this bag. I'm really happy with it. I see myself carrying this bag for a long, long time. When I had my other red bag, I carried it with everything. I didn't necessarily try to match it with my outfits. Like, I'm wearing a bright yellow shirt today and jeans, and I feel fine carrying it. If I was wearing green or blue or red or purple or whatever, I would still carry this bag. So, I hope this is helpful. And if you have any questions, let me know and I'll try to answer them as best I can. Thanks for watching. Take care. So I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please click the like button and let me know. Subscribe to my channel for more videos, and I will see you soon. Bye.